on over there once a month for lunch in the winter or dinner in the summer.
Yeah, I can imagine.
Because you're sitting there in the top of the Space Needle that's going around.
Yeah, yeah, I've seen that before.
Yeah, beautiful.
Hello.
So, today we will practice our joints and glands, just as soon as I turn off this back light here. And
are there any paper towels over there?
Paper towels. There are some. There are some tips. Two.
Mine is already wet from sweat.
Okay. Well.
Walking up down these long
halls. Yeah. Well, you know, perspiration is really great. That's something that that is sometimes not so easy to get because you know you have to get your heart really beating, and but then again, if it's because of, you know, sometimes medications cause you to have an elevated metabolism and feel a heat that is uncomfortable, so.
Oh, we were in England on my husband's second tour duty with the 81st Wider Vasectomy, and I was overdue with my third son, that's the one that happens to live in the clinical.
So please sit as tall as you can and let your breath come into the focus of the feeling sense at the nostrils and simply let the sense of that breathing find out what's happening with the feeling sense by tuning into the feeling of the breath as it enters the nostrils and notice the passage of the breath from the nostrils up the nose and into the space, spaciousness of the skull behind the eyes. Notice the feeling of the breath moving in the abdomen and the navel regions and the lower lungs, the rib cage, as it expands as you inhale and relaxes as you exhale. I will begin the class with the invocation to the golden womb, the Hiranyagarbha in Sanskrit. It's referring to the ineffable. It is referring to that which some call God. Others prefer not to limit their concept of this infinite source of knowledge and intuition, and simply prefer to refer to it as that which is nameless, not this, not that. So the Hiranyagarbha is a reference to the genitrix, the place of origin of thought, of vibration, and through that initial expansion we have light. It's from the sound and all of the other phenomena, and we ask the golden womb to guide us in our class today as well as in our choice of thoughts and our feelings, trusting and cultivating a faith in the intuitive wisdom. Shri Shavyasa Dimadhyaya. Begin our joints and glands exercises as taught by the Venerable Sri Swami Rama in the Himalayas with Abhyanga or self-massage, working from top to toe. Thus we begin with the massage of the face. If you're wearing glasses, now is a good time to set the glasses aside on your knee in a shirt pocket. You'll put them on again soon enough. Bring your awareness to the base of your thumbs and raise your hands in front of your forehead where your eyebrow ridge joins your nose, and using the base of the thumb, smooth across the forehead to either side, making a circle when you get to your temples. Start again with the base of the thumbs in the middle of the forehead and smooth across the dome of the forehead to either side to the temples and make a circle at the temples, massaging the temporalis muscle. Begin again with the base of the thumbs on the forehead, this time where the hairline joins the skin of the forehead, and smooth across the dome of the forehead to either side and down to the temples, and make a circle at the temples. Be sure to lower your arms at any point to rest. Next, we bring a window to between the thumb and the index fingers, and we bring the thumb and index fingers to the eyebrow ridge where the nose bridge joins the eyebrow, and massage the upper rim of the eye socket where the eyebrow is, and work your way across the tops of both eye sockets over to your temples. Make a circle with your fingers on your temples. Make another pass beginning where the nose bridge joins the eyebrow ridge, massaging the eyebrow and the upper rim of the eye socket with your thumbs and index fingers, working your way across the top of each eye to the sides of the head, and make a circle with your fingers on your temples. Again, lower your arms whenever you need to rest. Now, take the index fingers and lay them right alongside the nose so that they rest on the lower rim of each eye socket. And without pressing on the eye, simply press on the rim, the edge of the eye socket where it joins the nose, by pressing and releasing on the skull here and moving a little bit down and under each eye so that you're always pressing on the rim of the lower rim of the eye socket. Pressing and releasing, you are massaging the skull. You're massaging the sinus cavities, and you're bringing excellent circulation and feeling sensation to your face. When you get to your temples, make a nice circle on the temples. Similarly, you are bringing the feeling sensation to your face and to your brain. Now, once again, lay the index fingers alongside the nose so that they are able to press on the lower rim of the eye socket. Press and release. This self-massage, this Abhyanga that you're doing, continue to press and release as I talk. Work your way under the eyes. This Abhyanga is bringing a feeling sense to your brain and imaging, a Smriti Upasthana, a self-possession. Once you get to your temples, make a nice circle with your fingers there. And now if you've kept your arms up this whole time, go ahead and lower them just for a moment with the eyes closed. Breathing as you were through your nose, feeling the breath flowing in the nose and out the nose. It has been shown for a half century now that longer, in fact, as far as the yogis are concerned, that by breathing smoothly and completely, breathing naturally, you can, in fact, relax your cardiovascular system and bring a calmer state and better clarity to your mind. Now, bring the base of the thumbs to the nose and whoosh the nostrils with the base of the thumbs, just massaging the nostrils a little, and then use the base of the thumbs to massage the cheek muscles to either side, working your way under the cheekbones, and then off to the sides and up towards the base of the ears. And when you get to the ears, use your fingertips to massage the jaw, open the jaw, feel the jaw joint, and massage with your fingers right where you feel that movement, right by your ears. Even close your ear canal for a moment by pressing on this little dimple of skin. Just close your ears. Release, close, release, good. Now massage off the edge of the jaw on the neck, just below each ear. Move your head a little, maybe a little figure eight movement of your head. Good. And now, if you're wearing glasses, go ahead and put your glasses on if you prefer, or you can leave them off, whatever works for you. Now, bring the fingertips to the lower, just below your nostrils on your upper lip, a little confusing terminology, massage the upper lip. By pressing through the skin of the face, through the lip, you are massaging the gums, your upper gums, where your teeth go into the gums. Remember, there's a lot of circulation here, so by massaging this region, once again, you're producing saliva. You'll notice you begin to get a little bit more saliva in your mouth. It's good. Work your way along your teeth back towards the jaw joint. When you get to the edge of the jaw, you'll notice that vertical band of muscle that opens and closes your jaw. And use your fingers to it's like you're going to artificially cause yourself to smile. You know, like pulling back there. But you're just massaging that big band of muscle on the side of your jaw, and then where you go around the edge of your jaw onto your neck on either side. So use your fingers there and really feel the edge of the jaw, feel your neck muscles, and massage across those tendinous muscles that feel like cables. As you move your head from side to side, you can feel them alternately tightening and relaxing. And you want to just massage those where they go into the skull, like the base of the skull here. Let your head nod forward so that you can get more easily into that base of the skull. The occiput. Okay, good. Okay, now just lower the arms, let them dangle for a moment, and with the eyes closed, fully enjoy the presence of the breath, the feeling sense of the breath. You can say mentally, quietly, mind, you can repeat the mantra of the breath. That's a very good practice. The Sanskrit syllables. So hum. As you inhale, you simply focus on the syllable so, as with your inhalation, and then without pause, as you exhale, mentally you repeat the syllable hum, H-A-M. So hum. Yeah, that's right. So you can say it aloud, but it's more powerful if you just let it be a silently with your breath. Okay, now bring your fingertips and your thumb to the tip of your chin and massage with your fingertips the gums of your lower jaw, where your teeth go into the gums. You're massaging that portion of your jaw, and your thumb is massaging the inner edge of your jaw where it joins to your neck. So you can stroke your neck with your thumbs, massage the gums with your fingers. Gums and thumbs rhyme. I've never made a rhyme with gums and thumbs. But you work away along your jaw to the edge of the jaw and move your head a little from side to side again. All of this is to produce endorphins, the feeling sense of comfort and contentment, which always comes from the massage, whether you do it or someone else does it for you. And it's also relaxing your neck muscles, the skin of your face. It's producing saliva in your mouth. So now lower your arms, close your mouth, and just notice that you have produced indeed a little extra saliva. Very good for the morning, because it's going to bring better enzymatic digestion. Okay, so digestion begins with good saliva, good mastication, chewing your food at least 33 times before you swallow it, mixing it with lots of saliva in your mouth, remembering that your intestines don't have teeth, so you want to really get good digestion so you get good assimilation. All right, now before we continue, we do Simha Kriya. Open your mouth wide, stick out your tongue towards the tip of your chin, open your eyes and look up through the tops of the eye sockets. Relax everything. A more full expression of this pose is to put the palms on the knees. Lengthen your spine with your inhalation. Draw your heart through a little. Even sit tipping forward just a little bit already. Really widen across your sit bones. Send your tail back towards the chair behind you. Draw your heart through. Spread your fingers, spread your toes and your shoes. You're going to open your mouth, stick out your tongue, look out through the tops of your eye sockets, and on an exhalation, you pitch forward just like you're vomiting, but you're exhaling, you're purging the air like a tube of toothpaste. You go like that, like a cat. So you exhale fully, inhale, open the face, and go into the pose. And relax completely. Let your head hang. Your face soften, your whole body soften. Using your hands on your knees, inhale and come up slowly so you experience no discomfort. Now it's amazing, what apparently seems like such an extreme gesture can be so therapeutic. But the reason why is that you're flushing your lungs, and that's what we have to do. Your lungs are like an estuary next to the ocean in the tide.